Hey guys, nice to see you again. Let's start drawing. I use a free drawing app called Sketchbook. Its file tip pen is a good brush to draw outlines. Let's first draw an eye. I'm sure you know how to draw that. It's one of your favorite things to draw, right? Then we use the width of the eye as a measurement tool, so it will be easier to locate his other facial parts. This is a trick that I normally use when drawing 3/4 angle face. Ear is located in between eyebrows and the bottom of his nose. The horizontal and the vertical lines form a grid, which helped me to draw faster and more accurately. When outline here, after separate hair into bigger sections, we also need to consider hair sections are located in different layers, such as top layer and the bottom layer. Then we further divide each of the sections into many strands of hair. There is a step-by-step video in the description below, which is going to show you how to draw and color hair. It's under the intermediate level tutorial playlist. Please check it out. I didn't bother to draw an iPhone on core screen. Otherwise, it will be time consuming. I just used a PNG file that I found online and erased the parts that I do not need. His hand is not hard to draw, since only two fingers are exposed, and his thumb can only be seen partially. After the outline is done, the second step is to fill in base colors. You do not need to choose base color precisely, since all base colors will be adjusted in the third step, when we add shadows and highlights. I listed the color that I'm currently applying on the left of the screen. HSL stands for hue, saturation, and lightness. Since we need to manually change colors, HSL values are a better choice than RGB values. Did you notice that sometimes I choose the same hue value for base color and its shadows and highlights? This is because hue represents the pure color. Same hue means the color itself doesn't change. But what I can change are the saturation and the lightness values for the pure color. Saturation controls how saturated the color should be. 0% saturation will make the color look in gray, but 100% saturation will make the color look very colorful. As for lightness, it controls how light or dark the color is. 0% will make the color too dark, which appears black, and 100% lightness will make the color too bright, which appears white. There are two techniques to make base color to shadow transition smooth. Number one is to reduce shadow opacity to make the base color underneath appears at different levels. Number two is to spray the edge of a solid color with flow airbrush to adjust the color slightly. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to like the video or subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. See you next time.